You have not put together your carbon copies to show that indeed nobody won the elections.
Yes, my lord, because that is not the purpose of our petition.
So you say what is not the purpose?
I'm saying that we did not come to court to come and take over the work of Electoral Commission, but we are entitled, if we see the results are flawed, they are not born out of the data, we are entitled to challenge and to insist that must have a credible resource, that and a declaration that is based on the votes that were cast at the polling stations.
That's okay. I'm saying that you have not provided any basis of your own for your call for a runoff.
No, my lord, we haven't brought that data here. We didn't consider it necessary to our case to bring any such data here.
You see, do you know why you haven't brought any such document? It is because all the documents you have, all the authentic documents on the election that you have, show that the second respondent had won the election, so you can't bring it out.
That is not so, my lord, because we produce documents that will support the case we bring to this court. And if the case we have brought to this court is not about coming to retabulate figures the way MPP chose to do in 2013, then we do not need to bring those figures here. We are judging the first respondent by her own Bible. So the figures that she claimed were the figures that were generated and the conclusions that were drawn. We are saying that the conclusions are not born out of the figures she herself has presented.
So, Mr. Asiedu Nketia, I'm saying that indeed your claim for a rerun between the second respondent and the petitioner is based on the verbal slip made by the chairperson of the first respondent in mentioning the total votes cast rather than the total valid votes cast as a basis of determining the percentages.
My lord,
do you understand the question?
Please ask if you think I don't understand it. Can you repeat it?
Yes. I'm saying that your claim for the rerun is based on the simple slip, verbal slip, that the chairperson of the first respondent made when he was declaring the results, in using the total votes cast rather than the total valid votes to determine the percentages. Is that not correct?
My lord, we disagree that it's a verbal slip.
No.
Because a verbal slip in reading out figures would have meant that you read one figure instead of the other. But the from subsequent corrections that the first respondent sought to bring up, the figure she mentioned and the correction that was made was not related to the figures of the day at all. Because if you have maybe total votes cast in one column and then total valid votes in another column, it is possible that you read total valid votes for total votes cast, but they will be the same thing. So when you come back to allege that it was a verbal slip, we expect that the correction that you made will relate to the figure which you thought you were reading. But the corrections that they claimed were made did not relate, the so-called corrected figures did not relate to any figure that was on the face of the declaration in the first place. So it was a new figure also introduced. So it couldn't have been any verbal slip.